Oh, That it?
Yeah,
police officer who was just as violent as anyone else who killed that young man. But there has been a terrible overreaction. In other words, it was like, oh boy, we've got our thing now, let's take it over. Let's tear up everything. Mm-hmm. That was an excellent. I called it an op-ed that you wrote. Describing the tribulation of the nation has been through because we elected a president who holds up Christ. Did y'all see the sign in the sky on that lightning rod that hit that Washington Monument?
Yes.
Did y'all see that? That was a sign.
Yes.
Enloe, when he sent out, he had a picture of it. He called it a thunderbolt. Mm-hmm. And someone corrected him and told him that it was a lightning rod. It wasn't a thunderbolt. Many things to be rejected by this generation. As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be also in the days of the Son of Man. They ate, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage until the day that Noah entered the ark. And the flood came and destroyed them all. Likewise, as it was also in the days of Lot, they ate, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they built. But on the day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained strange God. Now, in the day of Noah, the earth was corrupt before God, Genesis 6:11, and the earth was filled with life. The earth was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with life. She says it up now. I didn't know she could cry. It came to me last week, and I heard one of her in the Did y'all hear me?
Filled with fire.
The earth is corrupt and the earth is filled with fire. We don't go back to that verse as it was in the day of Noah. God said to Noah, the end of all flesh has come before you. For the earth is filled with violence. Through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. Establish my covenant with you, and you shall go into the ark. You, your sons, your wives, and your sons' wives with you. In Luke 17:30, the next verse after, Jesus says that as it was in the days of Noah, even so will it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. The principle of lawlessness, wickedness, and violence is significant according to the statement of Jesus in this chapter and in Matthew 24. We are now living in the same kind of day that Noah and Lot lived in. All the wickedness that was going on in Sodom and Gomorrah is going on in the United States of America. All of the corruption and violence that was going on in the time of Noah. Jesus is not talking about married and having jobs and working and living a normal life. He said, as it was in the days of Noah, the corruption and violence that was upon the earth, God says, I looked upon it and I will destroy it. The wickedness of man is great, multiplying in the earth. Every imagination of the thoughts of his heart is only evil continually. God has purposed to destroy 5,000 lot out from Eden. The earth is filled with violence. All flesh, except consecrated Christians, have corrupted the way of God on the earth. Listen, if you're not taking your heart every day right now, if you're not getting before God every day and saying, God, clean up my heart. I wouldn't be too sure of yourself right now. Okay, so Noah ushered in a new age. I want y'all to say age. He found grace. Grace had not been found on the earth until Noah found it. Methuselah's life overlapped that of Adam by 243 years, you know, he's the oldest man that ever lived. Thus forming a connecting link between the Garden of Eden and the post-flood world and age. In the time of Adam through Methuselah and age. Methuselah's life ended in age, and Noah ushered in a new age. Jesus Christ ushered in a new age. And they even changed the way they come to years. We're no longer under law. We're under grace. It is worth to note that the word used for world in this parable of the tares is A-I-O-N, our age. The King James and other versions translate it to age. The word used for world, system, is cosmos. I typed the wrong word in there last time. What I think is a few of it in your notes. hear this. He who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, the cosmos. And the good seeds are the sons of the kingdom. And the tares are the sons of the wicked one. The enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age. The harvest is the end of the age. That's not a lot of verse. That's an aeon. Now, if you have King James Version, it will say world. But if you look it up, the word that is the world is aeon. Aeon. Because of this stream, this is what is making me say that the harvest has begun. awful lot of plastic balls gone. Now, being sealed in plastic means an unchristian heart.
All right. Unchristian heart.
Preachers.
Unchristian heart. But they're all growing on the same trees. Just like the tares and the wheat are growing together. We're talking to the church now.
Yes.
But a large olive tree represents the church. Okay. Those who do not receive Jesus Christ are going to be judged by fire. Mm-hmm. Rest in your sickle and reap, for the time has come for you to reap, for the harvest of the earth is ripe. I am reminded of a vision that I had many years ago. It was, and I'll share this with you. I was raptured into the heaven of the earth because I was sitting, Jesus was sitting on a cloud and he was sitting at the table of the writer's corner. And I was brought into the cloud, and from his pen, there was a rainbow that circled the earth. So I could see the earth from this point. There was a cloud that I was in. And Jesus put the pen in my hand. Okay, that would be the writer's acorn. He has called me to preach from that vantage point of his cloud.
Thank you.
And those who are bearing fruit.
And that's the reason for trying to shut down all the churches.
It's the reason for trying to shut down all the churches.
Shut us up.
Sure.
Except God put a fire in Jeremiah's mouth. And those bones quench. Okay. 58:2. I'll say it then, y'all forgot. I'm not gonna have to, y'all may not have read it. In your heart, you work wickedness. You lay out the violence of your hands in the earth. Okay, now y'all stand back for me. Antifa. In your heart.
In your heart.
You work wickedness.
You work wickedness.
You lay out the violence.
You lay out the violence.
Of your hands in the earth.
Leading them into
somebody here that'll speak up. That's right.
But there's no one in this country, okay, if the Lord Jesus has cleansed your heart from racism, and you don't have any racism, and he's given you his mind, because there's no racism in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Come on.
He was Jewish. It is wonderful. We have Hispanic. We have white. We have black and white mixture. We have Jewish. We have Texans. The spirit of Elijah. Yes. is a ruler spirit. She was queen. She was a princess. She was queen. She was mother of kings. This is a ruler spirit.
Conquest and control.
Ruler spirit of Jezebel is trying to destroy the kingdom of God on the earth.
Yes.
And church, if you don't know the difference and there's no one telling you, how will you know?
Yes.
Spirit of Elijah will be raised up at the end of the age. The angels will be sent out to harvest the earth at the end of the age. Harvest the world. And harvest God's kingdom at the end of the age. The spirit of Elijah will also be raised up at the end of the age. And there will be a great harvest of the fruit of the earth at the end of the age.
Now, I don't tell you what to do with that. I'm just telling you what the Word of God says. Oh, I might as well just read this.
Wrote, let's wake up, scare people with a virus, place them in a quarantine, count the numbers of any sickness and death, then announce it every second of every day and every week and every week. Close all businesses, 40 million out of jobs, keep unemployment, remove entertainment, parks, gyms, bars, restaurants, sports. No dating. No touching. Mask people. Dehumanize them. Close temples and worship centers. Create a vacuum. Let depression and anxiety and desperation set in. Then ignite hatred and civil war. Promote civil unrest. Empty the prisons because of the virus and fill the streets with criminals. Send in Antifa to vandalize property as if they are freedom fighters. Undermine the law. Loot, attack, law enforcement. strike the gift of the false flag of the Jezebel ruler system, and we need to rise up.